Hey, Timothy Anchored here. In this video, I want to talk about why not? Why not build your own website? With all the controversy surrounding this social media site and that social media site, privacy concerns, who's going to buy this, who's going to buy that, what's going to happen with this, why not just create your own site? I had a friend of mine in the late 90s. She would upload pictures of her and her friends to her own site and share it with them. And she could keep the backups of files offline as well. That way, if you want to look back years later at your memories, you can easily do so. So it got me thinking, you know, is it really that hard to create your own website? And if I go here to my browser, so I've got, you know, a bunch of domains here. I got timunker.com, timothyunker.com, my name. So I was doing one with my cycling posts here, but I thought, I moved that one over to timunkercycling.xyz because that makes more sense. It's more a cycling-related site here. So I'll probably do something like that. You know, I could use this one for updates on various things and sharing personal stuff. So, you know, how would I do that? Well, I've got a text editor slash IDE open. This is a free one. Bluefish, I thought I'd give Bluefish a little bit of love today. It's fairly straightforward for beginners and it has a bunch of options here. So what I thought I'd do is just show you. I could do a file new from template, HTML5, which is the current HTML update here. Gives me a basic framework to start with, and you know, this could be my, let's say, my home for timothyunker.com, and then I could have my body. Maybe I have a main tag here, and where I have my main content. Maybe I have an H1 with my status updates. And, you know, and then I have maybe a div here, and I'll give my div a class of status, right? And inside the div, I could give my latest status updates, like I went skiing yesterday, or something like that. And I could have an image that could go along with this if I really wanted to. And I could save it, you know, save it. I have a test.html here, but you know, I would save this as index.html and upload it to the root of my directory, right? And with this one, I can actually look and see what it looks like in the browser. It doesn't look like anything special because it's just HTML, but you know, I could share this with friends and they could look at it. And if I included a viewport tag, they could look at it on a mobile phone and it would be just fine. So it got me thinking, maybe a lot of people don't know how easy it is to build their own websites. Now, on this channel, I do tutorials. I thought, you know, next few weeks, maybe I'd do a deep dive into HTML, do a little bit each day, little bite-sized chunks. So, you know, it's easier to digest, and then go into CSS, do bite-sized chunks, easier to digest. And then, you know, same thing with JavaScript. And I think with that, I mean, it could be helpful for people trying to get into web development, because what do you need to basically know? HTML, CSS, and JavaScript for front end. And if you know the basics, then, you know, then it's easier to get into the frameworks. But if you have a good solid foundation, you know, of CSS and JavaScript, then you can, you know, look at the documentation on, say, Bootstrap or Balma or Materialize or one of those other CSS frameworks and get into it fairly easily. Same thing with JavaScript. If you have a good foundation, then you can, you know, pick up a tutorial or go to the you know, the documentation and pick up Angular or React or whatever fairly easily. So the foundation is important. So I thought I'd do some tutorials on that. And if you're not trying to become a web developer and you happened on this channel and you just want to have your own blog, that'll be helpful for that as well. You can make it look as spiffy or as basic as you like. But if you do have that foundation, I think it's important. So anyways, that's what I'm going to be doing the next few weeks with the channel. I'm going a little bit of, I started to think I can go a little bit away from the Vim and Emacs tutorials. I may mix those in as well, as I think people enjoy those. But anyway, so that was my thought. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a like, as it'll help get out to more people. I want to thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one.